Let's look at this numerical with respect to option pricing, deriving the value of the option. Assume a non-dividend paying security with price ST at time T. It can move to either ST times U. So there is a growth of U. There is an increase by U at time T plus 1. So this is time T, this is time T plus 1, or ST times D. So these are the two possible moments. So it's a binomial model. Continuously compounded rate of interest R, and U is greater than E power R greater than D. Okay. A financial derivative pays alpha if the stock price goes to STU, and beta if it goes to STD. Okay. So there is an alpha payout, there is a beta payout. A portfolio of cash amount X and underlying security with a value Y at time T. So at time T, I have a cash of X and I have an underlying security with a value Y. So which means probably I might be having Y by ST number of shares. Right, because the stock price is ST and I am having a value equal to Y, so I might be having Y by ST number of shares. Okay, replicate the payoff of the derivative at time T. Okay, this is replicating. So at time T, what is the value of this particular portfolio X? At a risk-free rate of return, it will earn X e power R for one more time period. At the end of T plus 1, the value of this will become X e power R. And what about the Y? Y by ST number of shares, it will become ST times U. So probably the value at the end of time T plus 1 will become YU. If the price is going up, the value of this portfolio is going to become X e power R plus YU. But if the value is going to STD, means there is a down in the price by D amount, then the value of the portfolio is becoming X e power R plus YD. So for this portfolio, when the price goes up, it is becoming X e power R plus YU. If it is going down, it is becoming X e power R plus YD. And because it is replicating the payoff at time T plus 1, so I have to make it equivalent to these. So this is alpha, this is beta. So from here, I can very well solve the stuff. Right? From here, I just need to solve for X and Y. So if I subtract it out, it becomes Y multiplied by U minus D is equal to alpha minus beta. So from here, I get my Y is alpha minus beta by U minus D. Right, I'm getting my Y value alpha minus beta by U minus D. Now I substitute it back, let's say, in this expression. So X times e power R plus alpha minus beta by U minus D times U is equal to alpha. So from here, I can very well get my X. X will come out as, probably X e power R will come out as alpha minus U times alpha minus beta by U minus alpha. Probably if I am simplifying this, I can even simplify this, right? So it becomes alpha U minus alpha squared minus U alpha plus U beta by U minus alpha. Sorry, U minus. This is U minus D, sorry. So I am taking this as, so alpha U minus alpha d, not alpha square, alpha u minus alpha d minus u alpha plus u beta. Now this by u minus d. So I get these two things going off. So it is coming out as alpha d minus of alpha d plus u beta. So which means I can very well write it as u beta minus alpha d divided by u minus d. That is x e power r. So x is becoming e power minus r times u beta minus alpha d by u minus d. So just as a quick summarization of this, the y is working out as alpha minus beta by u minus d. X is coming out as e power minus r times u beta minus alpha d divided by u minus d. Right? So this is the portfolio. These are this much of cash I need to have, and this is the value of the underlying security that I need to hold. Then derive an expression for the risk neutral probability of the security of value STU at time t plus 1 in terms of x plus y, r, alpha and beta. So here if I have to find at this juncture, derive an expression for the risk neutral probability of the security having a value STU at time t plus 1. Okay, now if I have to go with the risk neutral probability, yes, at this moment, whatever I need to have, I mean, whatever I am having, X is the cash that I have and Y is the value of the security that I have. So which means that is the value which I am actually holding, and this should be very much similar to e power minus r times, assuming the probability of going up, q is the probability of going up, and 1 minus q. So when it goes up, x plus y is the current value of the portfolio. Now when I am going it with respect to the derivative, there is a Q probability that the portfolio will go up, which means I will get a payoff of alpha, and 1 minus Q probability that I will get a payoff of beta, and that too at this moment. So this is what will become the risk neutral probability of the same, which means I can very well solve for Q. Even my Q comes out as e power. So in this case, if we are working out, so probably e power r times x plus y is equal to q alpha plus 1 minus q times beta. So which is also like q times alpha minus beta plus beta. So in this way, it works out that q is nothing but x plus y times e power r minus beta divided by alpha minus beta. So this forms the risk neutral probability of going up. Okay, assume ST is 100, U is 1.25, D is 0.8, R is 0. Calculate the price of at the money call and put. At the money is even the strike price. So if the stock price is 100, even the strike price X or K is also 100. U is 1.25. D is 0.8, right? So basically it's as good as, now I can say that the stock price from here, it can go to 1.25, or it can go to either 125, or it can go to 80. Then the payoff, now if I really want to find the payoff, so from this I can very well find out the replicating portfolio. I can look at X and Y. So from here the y is working out to us as alpha minus beta. Alpha is the payoff if it goes up and beta is the payoff if it comes down. So alpha is 25, beta is 20. In case of a call option, if the price goes to 125, the payoff is 25. If the option goes to 80, if the option goes to 80, the payoff is 0. Right. So it is coming out, y is coming out to 25 minus 0 by u minus d. U minus d is 1.25, which is 0.45. 25 by 0.45, or probably we can write it as 25 by 9 by 20, which is almost 500 by 9, which becomes 55 by 9. Similarly, I can write my x e power minus r, e power minus r, now r is 0, so I don't have this, u beta, beta is 0, so minus alpha d, alpha is, d is 0.8, alpha is 25, divided by u minus d, 0.45. So x is becoming minus 200 by 0.4, minus 20 by 0.45, which in a way is working out to minus, 44, 4 by 9. So I can add up x plus y, which is the replicating portfolio, which is 11, 1 by 9. The same logic when I am going with the put option, if the stock price goes to 125, the payoff is 0, which means I can equate alpha to 0, beta equal to 20. In case of put option, I can do the same. Alpha equal to 0, beta equal to 20. So from our formula, y equal to alpha minus beta, I will get minus 20 divided by u minus d, which is 0.45. So y is coming out to minus 44, 4 by 9. Whereas x e power minus r does not exist. Then beta u, 20 times the u is 1.25. So this divided by 0.45, which becomes again 25 divided by 0.45, or 55 5 by 9 again. Again x plus y is becoming 11 1 by 9. So here what we are seeing is when the strike price is same as the stock price and R is 0, we are seeing that the call put, call and put, both of them are having the same value. And you can very well test it out, right? Call put parity. Call minus put should be equal to spot price minus the present value of the strike price. Now, because R is 0, it should be stock price, spot price of the security minus the strike price. And because it's an at-the-money call, the difference should be equal to 0, which means the call value should be the same as the put value, and which we have got very much comfortably in this example. So the real logic behind all these things need to be understood quite comfortably. Lots of interesting derivations can very well come out, but the underlying fundamental remains the same. I'm trying to replicate the payoff in such a way that whatever the portfolio that I hold at time t, in all scenarios, it will match with my options payoff at time t plus 1. That will typically give us the solution quite comfortably. All right.